for the visit to WPI in Massachusetts, I rented a Ford Mustang. It's like right back of me. Six-cylinder. And I have to give you an overall review. It was pretty good. The car was a lot of fun to drive. It felt pretty stable on the road. And I liked it. Definitely a little bit more for a younger person, but the car was indeed good. I give it a thumbs up. I'll give you a quick tour of the interior. Okay, come on, let's go. First, we're going to do the driver door slam test so you can hear the acoustics of this thing closing. Pretty solid. Driver window comes down a bit. I don't know why. Maybe to allocate if it's a convertible. Anyway, let's take a look at the interior and then we'll boot the car. Now, I'll tell you, I was surprised. I thought this detail was metal. It's actually plastic. And the interior of the car is pretty basic. I mean, it's meant as a sports car, so it's not meant to be all glopped out with fancy crap. But pretty nice. Nice detail. I like the way the Prindle looks. Now, why do I call it a Prindle? Because if you look at the letters, it spells P-R-N-D. Actually, look at that. I'm old school. Used in the old days, used to be P-R-N-D and then L for low. And that was Prindle. I still call it a Prindle. All right, you can call it the shifter. Whatever. And now we're booting the Mustang. And a little driving footage off the line. Suspension can be a little tighter, in my opinion, but that's coming off a Corvette with the sport suspension, so I'm going to be a little bit biased on that one. I'll tell you, the weather up here, pretty ugly compared to sunny Florida. What can I say? Is it scenic, in my opinion? No! Gee, look at the foliage. Trees look pretty dead to me. Whatever. It's a six-cylinder. Again, it's a lease. But the car is pretty perky. And again, it was pretty stable on the road, even with wet, slippery, nasty conditions up here in Worcester, Massachusetts. So I'm a little lost here. I need some directions. Let's check my current location using the GPS system and the iPhone 3G. Let's pull up the map of where I am now. Watch, I was just talking to my buddy Dave, and I told him I was lost. I bet he's gonna come back with a message, use your iPhone GPS, as we wait for this freaking thing to come up. Dave, oh, Dave's timing is perfect. Dave writes, okay, I'm sure you'll find your way. Use the iPhone's GPS. Little did you know, I was like showing the scene where the freaking phone just said your location could not be determined. What the F is up with that? So what? I'm somewhere in Boston, in Worcester, and what, the GPS systems don't work here? I mean, they can't triangulate on my freaking position? Jesus H. Christ, and the H is for, I don't know, help me, I'm lost. There you have it. I finally made it to the freaking hotel. You know how I made it? Not with the GPS. The GPS, I say nay nay. I use the freaking phone. I call the concierge. Wow, the directions from the web all screwed up. Well, I'm here. And I'm pissed. And tired. And greased out. And a little brain dead, too. I've been up since like 2 o'clock in the morning. Whatever.
Ah. Now that's more looking like me. Nothing like a good shower and a shave and a little relaxation to make you feel like $1 million. Now, off to the WPI campus. Let's go. Come on. Stay with me on this. WPI has a very advanced artificial intelligence network, and right now I'm in the central core room. All these nodes in the back are cores for the AI unit, and they work collectively in a parallel processing fashion. I mean, the school is really, really high tech. I mean, we're talking about just tens and tens of gigaflops of processing power, and this core represents one of the top five computing centers in the world.